We will talk about how important the water is for health.
我们要说一说水的重要性。
And the people need to drink water.
人们需要喝水。
You know, about 65-70% of our body weight is coming from water.
身体当中65%-70%的重量从水而来。
See, there is a big misunderstanding that anything good for our health is hard to get.
我们总有一个错误的想法，就是对身体好的东西是好像我们很难得到的。
And it has to be something very special.
一定是很特别的东西才对我们好。
And they're expensive.
一定是很昂贵的东西才是好。
And so isn't that interesting? Is that really true?
这是真的吗？
That's not true.
这不是真的。
Look at the water.
大家看一看水。
How important is the water?
水有多重要呢？
See, but water is very easy to get.
水是很容易得到的。
See, if you don't drink water for a week,
一个星期不喝水，
you can die.
这个人就会死。
But there's something which is more important than water.
比水更重要的是什么呢？
That's oxygen, of course.
当然是氧气。
If you don't breathe oxygen for 5 minutes,
五分钟不呼吸氧气，
your brain cell can be destroyed and you can die.
脑细胞会受到破坏，人就会因此死亡。
Is oxygen expensive?
氧气贵吗？
Hard to get.
很容易，很难得到吗？
No,
当然不是。
And they're the most important thing for our health.
它们是对我们身体最重要的两样物质。
Do you know what's even more important than oxygen?
大家知道比氧气更重要的是什么吗？
If you don't have this for even 1 second,
这个东西如果你离开它一秒钟
you die.
就会死亡。
Do you know what it is?
那叫是什么吗？
That's 气。
就是气。
气 stops and you die.
气绝身亡。
气 is free.
气是免费的。
Which is most important thing.
它却是最重要的。
See, water, see, the 气And oxygen and water.
首先是气，然后是氧，然后是水。
These three things are most important for your health.
对于人类健康来讲，这三样是至关重要的。
There's so many people are looking for something special, something expensive.
在这世界上的人为了健康寻找着那些要花钱的东西。
Something hard to get.
他们费劲去寻找。
And they feel that if you eat something very expensive, you can be very healthy.
他们错误地以为，如果你吃非常贵的东西，你也许会健康吧。
That's not true.
当然，事实不是这样。
Those things you don't have to eat forever.
那些东西你不会吃一辈子。
You still can be healthy.
你不吃，你还会健康。
So, I want you to concentrate on water today.
今天请大家思考一下水。
Water obviously fills up the cells. Our cells.
水充满了我们身体里的细胞。
Let's take a look at the cell again.
让我们看一看细胞。
And this is filled with water.
大家看一下，水充满了这个细胞。
And many goodimportant substances are dissolved into the water.
许多在细胞里很重要的成分都溶解在水中。
So they can float around.
它们可以漂流在水中。
And they can go where they have to go.
它们去那些需要去的地方。
You can be very, your life can be very dangerous if your cells are dehydrated.
如果你的细胞脱水，你的健康就受到威胁。
Yes, so that's why we always have to have a sufficient amount of water.
所以我们喝水一定要足够量的。
See, we need to drink about 7 to 8 cups of water a day.
每一天我们都需要喝七到八杯这么大小的杯子的水。
We lose a lot of water with sweating.
我们出汗也会损失掉水。
I'm giving a lecture and I'm always talking.
我在讲座的时候不停地说话。
A lot of water goes out.
很多水分出去了。
And we urinate.
然后我们还有小便。
Yeah, we also have a stool. And there's so many different ways we lose water.
有很多方式会排出水。
That's why we must drink sufficient amount of water.
所以我们一定要喝足够量的水。
Without sufficient amount of water, your cell cannot function normally.
细胞如果没有足够量的水，不能够正常的工作。
Also, you have to drink sufficient amount of water to filter all these impurities in your blood through the kidney.
在血液里面那些有害的物质要通过肾脏排出的时候，需要足够量的水。
Kidney needs lots of water to produce urine.
肾脏排小便的时候需要大量的水。
And so without sufficient supply of water,
如果身体缺水
your kidney cannot really have a lot of urine to remove the impurities from your blood.
肾脏就无法排出身体内的那些毒素。
So,It is if you don't drink enough water.
所以如果身体缺水
your body feels stress.
你的身体就会觉得很紧张。
If you don't supply enough water, you feel fatigue so easily.
如果身体缺水，人就会容易疲倦。
And also, this water is very important for your feeling.
水还会带给你美好的感受。
See, when you came back from work,
当你下班以后
and you're tired,
你觉得比较累了
stressed,
又紧张
then your wife prepared the water in the bathtub.
那么妻子给你准备好了水
and you walk into the bathtub and you submerge yourself in the water.
这时候那你就用这个水泡一个澡。
How do you feel?
这时候你觉得好吗
？You feel so good.
你觉得还真舒服。
Yes, and why?
为什么
？Because as you submerge yourself into the water,
当你泡在水里的时候
，you feel good because you produce endorphin.
啊，你的 endorphin 就产生了，所以你会觉得开心。
As you get into the water.
当你进入到水里的时候
Your skin come in contact with water.
皮肤开始接触水
You're beginning to feel the water.
你开始感受到水
Endorphin gets activated.
这时候 endorphin 就产生了
Is that interesting?
有意思吗
And also, when you see the beautiful lake.
当你看到美丽的湖水
Oh, there's a lake. There's an ocean.
有湖，还有海洋。
Everybody feels happy.
每一个人都会觉得开心。
Why?
为什么呢？
You hear the water sounds of waterfall.
你听到了瀑布的响声。
Oh, I guess there's somewhere around there's a waterfall.
啊，我想离我们不远有一处瀑布。
Let's go and see.
我们去看看吧。
See, the anything related to water give us a happy feeling.
一切和水有关的事情都会让我们觉得快乐。
Why do you think that it is happening?
为什么会这样呢？你想过吗
？Why someone sort of getting into the bath and bath water they produce endorphin?
为什么人们在进入到水中洗澡的时候会产生出 endorphin 呢
？Nothing beautiful in the bath.
在浴室里面并没有看到美丽的景象。
Same bathtub and toilet over there.
还是有马桶，有澡盆。
And why this water, the feeling of the water through your skin.
为什么呢？就是因为你通过皮肤感受到了水。
Activate endorphin genes.
产生了 endorphin.
Have you ever thought about that?
大家思考过这点吗？
See, water has all this important physiological importance, but also at the same time, water gives you some emotional.
从物理和角度来讲，水让我们觉得很重要，水还要给我们一些美好的感受。
Do you know why?
为什么呢？
Because this gene responds to the meaning.
因为基因是对意义有所反应的。
See, water is simply H2O.
其实水的结构很简单，就是 H2O.
Yeah, H2O doesn't do anything.
H2O 这个结构好像没有什么意义。
But when you feel the water,
但当你触摸到水
，you feel peace.
你就觉得很平安。
You feel joy.
你觉得喜乐。
Why?
为什么呢
？Because we are all born in mother's womb in the water.
这是因为我们出生的时候在母亲的子宫里充满了水。
We subconsciously remember the water.
在我们的潜意识里，我们还有水的记忆。
Water is my mother.
水就是妈妈。
Water is my home.
水是我的家乡。
See, when I was in the water, it was the most peaceful time I spent.
所以一个人躺在水里的时候，觉得非常的平安。
There's no difficulties.
其实做到这一点并不容易，并不难。
The water is my love.
水让我感受到爱。
So water has very good meanings to all of us.
所以水对于每一个人来讲都有美好的意义。
So that's why when we take shower,
所以当我们淋浴的时候
，water touches our skins.
水触摸到我们的皮肤。
Oh, you feel good.
你觉得很好。
Because it is love touches you.
因为是爱触摸到了你。
You feel like you're at home.
你觉得好像是在家的感觉。
You feel like You're embraced by mom.
觉得是母亲拥抱着你。
See? So, since gene respond to the meaning,
所以当基因是对意义有反应的时候
that's why the water is even better for you.
所以水就变得更加的美好。
So, when you just look at water,
当我们看到水的时候
And hear the water.
听到水的声音
And feel the water by the skin.
感受到水
And you feel so good, and it even produces endorphin.
然后你觉得是那样的幸福 ，endorphin 就产生了。
How much more it is so important to drink water.
所以呢，喝水就显得更加重要了。
So when you drink, so remember 7 to 8 glasses of water.
不要忘了7到8杯水每一天。
See, the most important, most, the time you need water most is early in the morning.
大家每天最需要水的时候是早晨。
Because almost 7 to 8 hours or even 10 hours all during the evening and night, you haven't drink any water.
因为在你睡觉的这7到8个小时之间你并没有摄入水。
And your cells are starving for water.
你的细胞是那样渴望水的摄入。
So that's why, especially in the morning, as soon as you wake up, you woke up.
所以起床的第一件事就是要喝水。
You need more water than any other time.
它比一天当中其他时间更需要足够的水。
See, if you don't drink any water and go to breakfast,
如果没有喝水就直接吃早饭
the water is very deficient that you cannot even swallow food.
这时候呢，你就不能够吞咽食物了。
Why? Because your mouth cannot produce a sufficient amount of saliva.
因为缺水，所以口水呢没有分泌出来。
To produce saliva,
要分泌口水
you need to supply sufficient amount of water.
你需要身体摄入足够的水。
So, but as soon as you wake up,
当你起床的第一件事
before you start doing anything,
在你做其他事情之前
，drink 2 glasses of water，
喝2杯水
，then your cells will be so relaxed，
这时候你的细胞就放松下来。
Wow, finally water is coming.
细胞会说，哎呀，水终于来了。
It's so good.
哦，感觉不错。
So, it is, you know, physiologically, biologically such a relieving thing to receive the water into the cells.
对于细胞来讲，无论是物理学、生物学，都会对人体很重要。
Also, at the same time, when the cells are waiting for the water,
当你细胞你的细胞等待水的时候
，See, can you imagine when you haven't drink any water for a few days?
你能够想象吗？几天不喝水
？Even maybe 2 days.
比如说两天你不喝水
，How thirsty you can be!
你会变得多么渴啊
！What a stress, even emotionally.
你看，感情上也会觉得非常的有压力。
Water.
水呀、啊，水在哪儿
？So, you know, no matter how peaceful you can be, you cannot be in the peace when you are lack of water.
当人缺水的时候，人无法感受到平安。
So that's why it is important to give yourself 2 glasses of water as soon as you wake up.
所以早晨起来。一定要让自己喝到两杯水。
Then water gets into your cells.
水进入到你的细胞。
And your cells feel so good.
细胞就会有很好的感觉。
And then your genes is ready to respond to the qi.
而基因这时候就会对气做出反应。
Even the qi comes into your cell to activate your genes.
当气刺激你的细胞开始作用的时候
，If there is no sufficient amount of water，
如果缺水
，the qi cannot activate your genes，
气就不能够会促进这个基因的作用。
When there is not enough water，
没有水
，everything needs to be quiet，
所有的东西都会变得安静下来。
So that's why when you put soybean on the table，
所以当你把黄豆放到桌子上的时候
，No water，
没有水。
Can this sprout out？
黄豆会发芽吗
？No， that the gene for the sprouting does not work。
发芽的这个基因它停止工作。
Why？ Because qi does not really come. It is dangerous to activate the gene to resprout and to make a root when there is no water。
没有水的时候，基因作用在这个黄豆上的时候是非常危险的。
Finally, you put the soybean and you plant them in the soil.
然后你把这个黄豆放到土地里面。
Then you water them.
然后浇点水。
And there's fresh air.
然后有新鲜的空气。
And there's sunshine.
阳光。
Then right temperature.
然后还有节制。
Then qi comes.
然后就有了气。
Then it sprouts out.
这时候就开始
the old gene begin to activated by the qi
因为有了气所有的基因都开始活跃
so that's why it is so important to provide a good environmental conditions for the genes
所以基因它需要非常合适的环境
so your gene in the cell requires a perfect environmental condition to be met
基因需要非常完美的环境来满足它的需要。
To respond properly to the qi's coming and activating them.
它需要有气来正常的作用在基因上。
In activation of the gene, the qi is the most important thing.
对于基因的做工来讲，气是最重要的因素。
But qi cannot do anything to the genes.Until all these environmental conditions are met.
可是如果周围的环境不具备条件的时候，气是无法作用在基因上的。
Let's think about our own genes in our own cells.
让我们想一想自己身体内的细胞里的基因。
See, we need a sufficient amount of water supply.
我们需要足够量的水。
When there's a lack of water, the qi cannot really do the work to activate genes.
身体缺水的时候，气就不能作用在基因上。
Of course, we need to have enough supply of oxygen too.
我们当然需要氧。
And a balanced nutrient.
也需要平衡的营养成分。
And even temperature.
还有合适的温度。
A body temperature must be in the range between 36 to 37.
我们的体温必须在36到37度之间。
If it below 36, then you are in trouble too.
如果体温在36度以下，人也会生病。
If it go over 37, 38, then you have a fever.
如果体温超过37、38度，人就在发烧。
And your genes does not really work properly.
基因就不能够正常的工作。
Look.
大家看一下。
36 to 37.
36到37度之间。
What a narrow range you need to provide to the genes.
所以对于基因来说，你所提供的体温是这样的狭窄。
Do you control the temperature yourself?
但是体温是由自己来控制的吗？
No, you don't.
你控制不了。
It is impossible for you to control your own body weight.
人类是不可能控制自己的体温。
You know, water supply is very important to the temperature control.
大家知道吗？水作用于你的体温非常重要。
If you don't drink enough water,
如果你的身体缺水，
then you do the exercise,
然后你去做运动，
body temperature goes up very fast.
身体很容易发烧。
And your body feels stress.
然后身体就会觉得很有压力。
And your heart rate get increased so fast.
你的心脏跳动也会增加。
Blood pressure begin to go up.
血压上升。
So, if you don't provide sufficient amount of water,
所以身体缺水的时候，
then you work, exercise, receiving the stress.
人上班工作运动。
It is very bad for your system.
对自己的身体非常的糟糕。
So.After drinking enough water,
所以请喝足够的水。
Then you can exercise and sweat.
这时候你运动也可以出汗。
And you receive some stresses.
这时候你承受压力的时候。
Your body can tolerate that stress and exercise very easily.
你的身体能够承受这样的压力，还可以工作。
Because there is a sufficient amount of water available in your body.
因为水的供应是足够的。
Think about this.
大家思考一下。
Can you exercise when there's not enough oxygen in this atmosphere?
在你周围环境当中缺少氧气的时候，你能够正常的运动吗？
And when you go up to very high mountain, when air is so thin.
当你爬到很高的山顶的时候，
Can you do the exercise there?
你可以做运动吗？
If you do the exercise, you can be so short of breath.
你这时候在山顶上运动的时候就会气喘。
It is very bad for health.
这个是有害健康的。
That's why we need to supply sufficient amount of water.
所以我们一定要需要足够量的水。
So drink two glasses of water as soon as you wake up.
所以起床的第一件事喝两杯水。
Then wait for about half an hour.
然后半小时之后。
Then go to breakfast.
可以吃早饭。
Then you'll find out that you don't have to drink any water while you're eating breakfast.
然后这时候早饭，你发现你不需要再喝水了。
You'll find out it is so easy to swallow all the food.
你觉得这时候吞咽早餐是很容易的事儿。
Why? By supplying sufficient amount of water.
因为身体摄入了足够的水。
Your body can produce enough saliva.
身体可以分泌出口水
and the sufficient amount of fluid in the stomach.
在胃里面也有足够的消化液。
So since there's a large supply of the saliva, so it is so easy to swallow food.
因为嘴巴里有足够的口水，可以吞咽食物。
And go into the stomach.
然后直接进入到胃里。
It is not really good for your digestion if you drink water within the meal or just before the meal or just right after the meal.
有一件事情是危险的，就是在你吃饭的时候喝水，或者刚刚吃完饭继续喝水。
Because inside your stomach, there's a lot of good digestive enzymes produced and waiting for the food to come in.
因为在人体的胃当中有很多很好的消化酶，他们在等着食物的进入。
So as soon as the food comes in, then
所以食物一来，
the food can be digested.
就可以被消化掉。
So while you're eating,
当你吃的时候，
and you feel thirsty,
你觉得口渴，
and then you drink water,
然后你就喝水，
then it dilute all this good stomach enzyme.
它就冲淡了这个消化酶的作用。
And if the enzymes are diluted.
当这些消化酶被化解的时候，
then your digestion can be very poor.
你的消化系统就变得非常的可怜。
Yes, and then your digestion can become very incomplete.
然后消化系统会变得非常的不完整。
So that's why please drink water at least about half an hour before the meal.
所以请你一定要在吃饭之前半小时喝水。
And after the meal.
或者半小时之后喝水。
But if you forgot.
但是你忘了怎么办？
And then you feel thirsty.
这时候你口渴。
Of course you have to drink water, even though it is in between meals.
那么这时候你即使在两餐之间也一定要喝水。
Even though within the meal.
甚至吃饭的时候你也要喝水。
Or right after the meal, because water supply is more important.
所以这时候喝水就变得重要了。
And so that's why it is important for us to remember.To drink two glasses of water as soon as we wake up.
所以大家不要忘了，早上起来第一件事情就是喝两杯水。
Oh, then your body, all your genes will feel wonderful.
所以你的基因就会觉得很好。
Then after the breakfast.
早饭之后呢？
So about 1 hour after breakfast.
早饭之后的一个小时。
You drink one glass again.
然后再喝一杯。
Then about 1 hour before the lunch,
在吃午饭之前的一个小时
drink another glass,
喝另外一杯水
That's 4 glasses before lunch.
所以在午饭之前喝到四杯水
And after lunch, before the supper,
晚饭之前
another 2 glasses,
再另外喝两杯水
Then after supper, before you go to bed,
晚饭到睡觉之间
1 or 2 glasses,
喝一杯到两杯的水
Then your body is sufficiently hydrated.
所以这时候身体就有足够的水分。
And then your cells will be so well hydrated and beginning to work very actively.
细胞因为有足够量的水分，所以它开始正常的工作。
And your cells are ready to receive the gene, so your genes can be activated.
细胞可以正常的接受到气的作用，所以基因开始发挥它的功能。
And if youEat very salty and hot food, then you become very thirsty, right?
如果你吃的饭又咸又辣，人很容易渴。
Or too many sweets.
或者吃太甜的东西。
Because when your blood is becoming so salty,
当你的血液变得很咸的时候
then your cell lose water to your blood.
这时候细胞里的水就会进入到血液里。
By eating.Too much salty, hot food.
太多的超过盐量的食物
And the sugar.
还有超过糖分的食物
And or other like drink like a cola.
或者是喝饮料的这种习惯
And it can because of its higher concentration.
因为它是超浓度的饮食
It can actually get the blood out of your cells.
会从细胞里抽出血液来。
So that's why you're not supposed to really drink this salty ocean water.
所以我们不能够喝过咸的海水。
No matter how much you are thirsty.
不管你有多渴，也不能喝海水。
If you drink ocean water because you're thirsty.
如果你因为口渴去喝海水的话。
Of course, there's lots of water in the ocean water.
当然，在海里面有足够的水。
And you'll be even more thirsty. Because ocean water is about 3 times more concentrated than your blood.
因为海水里面的浓度超过血液浓度的3倍。
And your cells too.
细胞也是这样。
So cells begin to lose water.
所以呢，细胞就开始缺水。
And cells will beginning to be more dehydrated.
所以细胞又开始脱水。
That's why you die fast that way.
这样的话，人会很快死亡。
That's why the doctors recommend you to drink your own urine.
所以医生会说你喝自己的小便。
At least it is much less concentrated than ocean water.
在口渴的时候喝小便比这个喝海水还要好。
Yes, and that's why.It is very important for us to eat sort of the food not too salty, too hot, too sweet.
所以很重要的一点，我们的饮食不要过甜、过咸、过辣。
Yes. And but today, the so majority of people in this world does not really feel thirsty when they are supposed to feel thirsty.
而在当今的人群当中，他们很少有口渴的感觉，他们应该感觉到渴的时候却不想喝水。
See, water level begin to go down and down.
水的需要量变得越来越少。
When water level in the cell goes down below certain level,
当细胞里的水分减少到一定量的时候
，then you need to feel thirsty to supply more water.
你需要感觉到口渴，提供水分。
When I'm giving you lecture,
当我给你讲座的时候
，I'm losing lots of water because I'm keep on talking to you.
因为不停的说话，所以呢，损失掉了大量的水分。
And this place is a little bit hot.
这个地方又有一点点热，然后我还在出汗。
And but I'm very busy talking to you.
但是我要忙着说话。
So I cannot check how much water is being lost.In my cells.
所以我没有机会去测量我的细胞损失掉了多少的水分。
I do not determine that when I should be feeling thirsty.
所以我不知道什么时候我会要觉得渴。
I have no control. I have no knowledge whatsoever.
我对这一切都没有知识。
But when water level goes down below certain level.
但当身体的水分降低到一定程度的时候
then.I begin to feel thirsty.
我会觉得口渴了。
Do you know why?
你知道人为什么口渴吗？
Because there's a certain genes in the brain activates.
因为在大脑里有一个基因的作用。
And which produce a certain very special substance.
在这个基因里产生出一种特别的物质。
And the substance make me feel.Thirsty.
是这种物质让你感觉到口渴。
How this gene gets activated?
那这个基因是怎么样产生作用的呢？
The gene does not know.
基因并不知道。
But it is qi knows.
但是气却知道。
You know, let me show you a very interesting picture.
我给大家看一个非常有意思的图片。
You know the giraffe.
大家知道长颈鹿吗？
Okay.In Africa,
在非洲的长颈鹿。
Very recently, scientists found giraffes eating the dried bones here.
最近科学家们发现到一种很奇怪的现象，就是非洲的长颈鹿在吃那些干尸。
Look at giraffe's foreleg.
骨头，对，骨头。那看一下这个长颈鹿的这个腿。
This is not very comfortable pose for the giraffe.
你看这个长颈鹿的姿势并不舒服啊。
But giraffe look at this bone and wants to eat.
但是长颈鹿就想吃这个骨头。
Isn't that strange?
奇怪吗？
And scientists felt so strange, and then they anesthetized this giraffe and draw some blood and did some blood testing.
科学家们发现到这只奇怪的长颈鹿的现象，就抽了一些血样进行化验。
And guess what scientists found out?
你们知道科学家发现了什么？
This giraffe is deficient in the calcium.
因为这个长颈鹿缺少一种东西叫。
This giraffe need calcium.
它缺钙，所以它要吃钙。
And does giraffe knows anything about calcium?
你觉得长颈鹿对钙有所了解吗？
No, they don't.
长颈鹿并不明白什么是钙。
They don't know what is calcium.
他们不知道什么是钙。
Do they know they have a lack of calcium in their blood?
他们知道他们的血液里缺钙吗？
No, they don't know.
他们并不知道。
They have no knowledge.
他们对此毫无所知。
Then why they're eating the bone?
那他们为什么要去吃骨头呢？
Do they know that there's a lot of calcium in the bone?
他们是不是知道骨头里面含有大量的钙呢？
No. Then why they're eating the bone?
那他们不知道为什么还要去吃骨头呢？
They have no knowledge.
他们并不知道。
No knowledge about calcium.
他们对钙并没有了解。
There's no knowledge about that the bone has high level of calcium.
他们也不知道骨头里面含有大量的钙。
Well, I'm telling you, I have never been to Africa and gave them health lecture to the giraffes.
我保证我以前从没到过非洲给这些长颈鹿上课。
They have no knowledge.
他们并不了解。
Then how they eat the bones, which has a lot of calcium?
那他们怎么会去吃这些骨头呢？骨头里含有钙。
Isn't that interesting?
有意思吧？
This is also...This kind of thing is also being done by the activation of the gene.
这个也是基因作用的结果。
So that's why scientists propose there's existence of the cosmic intelligence.
所以科学家们不得不相信，在这宇宙中存在一种宇宙智慧。
Or cosmic consciousness.
或者叫宇宙之感知。
And cosmic intelligence knows this giraffe needs calcium.
这个宇宙智慧它告诉长颈鹿需要钙。
And this cosmic intelligence send qi.
这个宇宙智慧就告诉长颈鹿气。
And activate certain genes.
这个气作用在长颈鹿的基因里。
And this gene produces a substance called MPY.
那么这个基因产生出一种物质叫做 APY.
MPY.
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 Y,
neuropeptide Y.
MPY 这种物质。
And this MPY makes giraffe to eat something.
这种 MPY 让长颈鹿要去找一样东西。
But one day, when giraffe look at the bone,
当长颈鹿看到骨头的时候
，and MPY is produced in the brain, and giraffe feels, oh, I want to eat the bone.
在长颈鹿的大脑里产生出这种 MPY 的物质，告诉他要去吃这个骨头。
Isn't that interesting?
有意思吗？
Of course, qi came to MPY gene to be activated.
当然是气作用在基因里的 MPY 这种物质上。
Okay, giraffe they didn't know, they have no knowledge about gene themselves.
其实长颈鹿自己对基因并不了解。
Giraffe themselves can never activate their own MPY gene.
而且长颈鹿自己也不能够去促使它的基因来做工。
It must be other force from the cosmic intelligence.
那一定是从宇宙智慧来了一种动力。
Send the qi.
把气给了长颈鹿。
Maybe the cosmic intelligence is love.
也许这就是爱吧。
And sending this love, which we call qi today.
我们把这种像爱一样的称作气。
Activate this MPY gene to make giraffe to feel like eating the ball.
这种基因 MPY 产生的物质让长颈鹿要去吃，要去啃这个骨头。
Well, the Confucius say this is a...Command of the heaven.
孔子说这是天命。
And he says, when you become 50,
他说人到五十
you must be able to hear the command coming from.
他说五十就要知天命。
I think Confucius is talking about qi too.
我想孔子所说的就是这个气吧。
And Confucius says that heavenly command and called.Wisdom.
孔子把这个天命称作智慧。
And that wisdom is very merciful.
啊，这个智慧非常有怜悯的心。
And righteous.
还有公义。
Yeah. And mercy, righteousness.
有怜悯，有公义。
And wisdom.
还有智慧。
And this wisdom is very courteous.
这个智慧非常的非常的有慷慨。
And there must be love, can never be rude, says.
要有爱，不能够粗鲁。
Yeah, this is a Confucius concept of love.
这是孔子给爱下的定义。
It's merciful,
仁爱
and righteous,
公义
and and very courteous.
还要有礼貌。
And very wise.
还要智慧。
The four components of the heavenly commandment.
这就是天命的四个部分。
That's very interesting.
很有意思，对吗？
Yeah. And so.Do you know when these giraffes quit eating this bone?
大家知道长颈鹿什么时候就不再啃这骨头了呢？
Probably you already guessed.
也许你已经猜到了。
Yeah, because when they absorb the sufficient amount of calcium from the bone.
当他们从这个骨头里吸收到了足够的钙之后，就不再去啃了。
NPY does not get produced anymore.
然后 NPY 也被停止了。
And so giraffe no longer feel like eating the bone anymore.
所以长颈鹿这时候就不再去吃啃骨头了。
And if a giraffe is absorbed enough calcium into his system,
当长颈鹿的身体摄入足够的钙
，and he feels satisfied.
他感觉到了满足。
Why?
为什么
？Because there is CCK is produced.
因为会有 CCK 这种物质的产生
from the brain cell
是在大脑里面
so giraffe feels I'm satisfied
所以长颈鹿这时候感觉到
满足 I don't have to eat the bone anymore
我不用再啃骨头了
so this is how the animals who doesn't know anything about nutrition is controlling their own intakes of all these various nutrients
当动物对营养学毫无所知的时候，它们还是知道该从什么地方来摄取足够的营养。
Very interesting.
很有意思。
The water intake is also controlled like this.
水的摄入也是这样。
When cosmic intelligence knows that you need water.
当宇宙智慧告诉你你需要水的时候
Water level went down below this level
因为你的水的量已经身体已经不够了
And there's a gene which produces substance which make you feel thirsty
你身体里的一部分基因就让你感觉到口渴
So cosmic intelligence send the qi down
这时候宇宙智慧就把气给了你
And activate to produceThe thirsty substance.
然后产生出这种口渴的物质。
And then you feel, oh, I feel thirsty.
这时候你会觉得啊，我要喝水。
So you're not making up this feeling of feeling thirst.
口渴的感觉不是从自己有的。
So you decide to go to water and drink some water.
所以你要去找水，然后喝下去。
When you feel thirsty,
当你感觉到口渴的时候
，make sure you drink water.
一定要去喝水。
Not the cola or not the other commercial beverages, which,
而不去喝那些饮料
which has a lot of stuff already dissolved in and have higher concentration than water.
因为那些东西溶解到水里，它会超浓度。
Well, I think many Chinese people drink so much teas.
我觉得中国人喝茶喝得太多。
Highly concentrated teas.
茶太浓了。
And that's not also ideal for your health.
这对于中国人的健康来说也是不利的。
Because in the tea, there's a constant stimulating substances.
因为在茶叶里面也有一些刺激性的因素。
Your cell cannot really feel the peace with this constant stimulation.
在这些茶叶的刺激作用下，细胞不会觉得舒服。
So that's why it is so important to drink just plain, clean.Water.
所以大家记住，就要喝这些清洁的白开水。
So if you drink enough water,
当你喝足够的水
，then when water is sufficient,
当水的量摄入足够
，then qi comes and produces CCK.
然后气进入到人体产生
CCK. Then when you finish drink, so good water. This is enough.
当你喝完水的时候，你觉得哎呀，水真是太好。
Is that interesting?
有意思吧。
We are under control by the qi.
所以是气在控制着我们。
By the wisdom.
是智慧在给我们。
And very righteous.
那公义帮助我们。
And merciful.
那怜悯帮助我们。
And courteous.
还有礼貌。
That is the nature of the qi.
这就是气的本质。
Which is love.
它是爱。
Love must be courteous.
爱一定要对别人有礼貌。
When you love, you cannot be rude, right?
当你表现爱的时候，不能粗鲁。
Love must be righteous.
爱也要公义。
Love must be merciful.
爱还要有怜悯。
And love is very wise.
爱就是智慧啊。
When you love your babies,
当你爱自己的孩子
even though you never learned, never studied medicine and nutrition,
你从没有学过医学，也没有了解过营养学。
This mother who loves her baby knows exactly when baby wants to go to bathroom.
那母亲因为是出于母爱，就会知道孩子什么时候需要洗澡。
Mother feels exactly how the baby feels.
妈妈感受到的正是孩子的感受。
Mother has no knowledge, medical knowledge.
母亲并没有医学背景。
But mother has wisdom.
但母亲却有母爱的智慧。
Mother becomes so wise about the baby.
母亲在对于自己的孩子上面充满了智慧。
This wisdom comes with love.
这样的智慧是随着爱心产生的。
See, our body needs this love and wisdom.
我们的身体缺不了这样的爱心和智慧。
And, but unfortunately,
但是不幸的却是
majority of the people in this society today,
当今社会上的大多数人群
they are living under the constant relative deficiency of water.
大部分人都是相对来讲是缺水的状态下生活。
Why?Because they're so busy under so much stress.
他们在很大的压力之下不停地忙碌。
So they're not really sensitive to this kind of life-giving signal coming from qi.
他们对于这个从气来到身体气息的这个消息并不敏感。
Qi make you feel a little thirsty.
气让你觉得口渴。
But you are talking on the telephone.And you are concentrating on something else.
但是你却关注于电话，关注于其他的生意。
You think about something, and you're getting angry.
你想到某些事情就觉得发火。
And you forget that you are thirsty.
你忘了你要喝水。
So you don't drink any water.
所以你一天也不喝水。
But you don't really notice you are thirsty.
但是你也没有注意到你缺水。
See, this is why the sensitivity.To the thirst is decreasing.
所以对缺水这种敏感程度越来越衰退。
It becomes the sensitivity become dull and dull.
而这种敏感呢，变得越来越迟钝。
So you have to be very thirsty to feel the thirst finally.
所以最终什么时候你会喝水呢？你口渴的已经不行了。
This is too bad.
这时候太糟糕了。
So many people don't drink enough water.
很多人喝的水不够。
When I wait for the plane in the airport,
我在机场候机的时候。
See, a lot of people in the airport have been, you know, spending long time coming to the airport, at least 1 or 2 hours to come to airport.
赶到机场的人大多都是花了一两个小时的时间。
Obviously, they are, most of them are in hurry.
大家也都匆匆忙忙。
And there's many water fountains here and there in the airport.
有很多喷泉。
Not many people drink water.
但却没有人喝水。
Of course, it's about time to drink water.
当然，喝水的时候到了。
And this qi comes to them already to make them feel thirsty.
气其实已经告诉他们该喝水了。
But they are thinking about something else.
但他们却想着别的事情。
Do this before I get on the airplane. Do that, you know, and make a telephone call somewhere else, etc.
他们在候机的时候想着要打电话，想着要做这个做那个。
And that's why they don't sense.
所以他们不再去感受。
So.Their thirst system is reset.
所以对口渴的感觉就变得降低。
And this need to recover back to normal.
我们需要恢复这种口渴的感觉。
I'm sure most of you who's listening to this lecture have your third sensation downgraded.
我保证听这个讲座的大多数人都是对缺水感觉到不敏感的。
You need to have this third sense upgrade.
所以你的口渴感觉应该增加。
When it is downgraded,
当缺水感觉迟钝的时候
，then you begin to drink water.
然后你喝水。
Well, it'll be difficult.
你觉得喝水不容易。
Your body actually needs one full glass of water.
你的身体也许需要满满的一杯水。
But if you drink only half of them,
可是呢，你可能只喝掉半杯。
You feel you're full.
你觉得哎，够了。
If you drink further, then you feel like throwing up.
如果你再喝，你就想吐。
See, that's why you must begin to train yourself to drink water.
所以要教会自己喝水。
Frequently.
不停地喝水。
Then make your sensation of thirst come back to normal, upgrade it.
使你口渴的感觉能够恢复。
It'll take maybe a couple of weeks.
啊，这种恢复需要几个星期的时
间。Finally, after 10 days, then you begin to feel thirst.
大概十天之后，你开始有了口渴。
You begin to notice that you are thirsty.
那时候你注意到你需要喝水。
Then you're ready to become healthier.
啊，这时候你开始变得健康。
No matter how much healthy food you eat,
不管你摄入多少健康的饮食，
you do the exercise.
你做运动。
Without giving sufficient amount of water supply,
如果身体缺水的话，
the qi cannot come and activate your all genes.
气还是不能作用在你的基因上发挥它的作用。
So, please drink 7 to 8 glasses of water.
所以，请大家每一天要喝7到8杯水。
Starting tomorrow morning.
明天早晨。
As soon as you wake up in the morning.
一起床。
Drink 2 glasses of water.
喝两杯这样的水。
You'll find out how good you feel.
一定会有一个不错的感觉。
Maybe after 1 glass, you'll find out that you cannot drink an extra glass.
很多人在喝完第一杯之后都觉得不用再喝第二杯。
You know what that means?
你知道是什么意思吗？
Your third sensation is downgraded 50%.
就是你的口渴的感觉已经降低了50%。
It needs to be upgraded to the 100%.
你要使它恢复到100%的感觉。
Then you can drink water 2 glasses.
这时候你就能喝两杯水了。
Try hard until your third sensation come back to normal.
所以大家要努力一下，使你的口渴感觉恢复正常。
Then you find out how refreshed you are.
这时候你觉得啊，自己原来是这样的有活力。
You will not become so tired very easily.
不容易觉得疲惫。
See, you'll be feeling more energetic.
你觉得自己是一个有活力的人。
And you feel more relaxed.
你也觉得比较放松。
And your genes will receive a wonderful, perfect.Environmental condition.
水给基因提供了非常舒适的环境。
Finally, qi can work properly.
这时候气就能够正常的发挥它的作用。
See you next time.
好，大家下次见。